welcome back, and thank you for spending a little time with us on this Tuesday. I got it right the first time, the second day of September. Well, Labor Day is now officially over and done with. It's back to work, and it's on to the calendar, literally. The last big hurrah of the summer, technically. Maybe we'll be lucky enough to squeeze a few more in, but, you know, holidays are few and far between from this point for the next little bit, but they'll be here before you know it. Today being the second means that we're now counting the clock down to some other big events. Fall officially gets here on the 23rd day of this month, just to let you know. Daylight savings time will end on November the 2nd, and I checked, 113 days till Christmas, just to let you know. We are glad you could join us for this evening. A whole lot of news from over the course of the holiday weekend and today. Several auto accidents, drug-related arrests, a structure fire earlier today in the midst of some storms that were rolling through, the likes of which we're seeing over the course of the evening as well. All of that we'll get to on tomorrow's program as we've got to wrap up Heritage Days on tonight's show. We'll do so by covering the Miss McGoffin County pageant. I'll take you to the evening gown segment of the program, as well as the announcement of awards. And then I've got the parade edited for you. And I would say just about everyone out there has someone they know or love or both in the parade, because with all of the beauty pageant winners and all the other floats, there's someone you're going to want to see, if not a whole lot of folks. And I'll have that for you in just a few seconds. Only a couple of other things before I get there. First and foremost is that with the special program tonight, we need to thank, as we always do, the folks who are here with us each and every weeknight, as are you, and that being our faithful sponsors, Sagersville National Bank, Frazier's Prater Drug and the Radio Shack and the Seasonal Shop, and Lee's and Dairy Queen, Don McFarlane, Hutch Chevrolet, and Hutch Chevrolet Chrysler Jeep and Ram as well. And they've got their lot up and running. They're under construction, but they've got new vehicles on the lot, and you're going to see some of that in their next ad I'll have up and running tomorrow. Premier Auto Sales over in Paintsville, Paul B. Hall, Conley's Tire, Appalachian Wireless, M&M Motorsports, Sagersville Nursing and Rehabilitation Center, Parkway Pharmacy, McGoffin County Funeral Home, McGoffin County Farm Bureau, Licking Valley RECC, Citizens National Bank, the Mortimer Lofts, an in-house sponsor nonetheless. But to each and every one of those, we want to thank them, and we want you to let them know that you're watching each and opportunity you have. So, in part, after those folks, I need to tend to a few other announcements before we turn over to our first report this evening. It happens far too often, not all that often, but once is too often. It's a one-man show for the most part around here, and it's nothing short of a miracle almost every day that happens that I have a show ready to can, ready to in the can or up and running and ready to broadcast as of air time. And sometimes I miss things as a result of that. And I can't tell you if this birthday announcement was on or not, but I had it placed over into the tomorrow or next day pile, and it was asked of me to wish a very happy 18th birthday to Lakota Quinn Arnett on last Wednesday from Mom and Dad and Chloe. And if I did, well, happy birthday again. And if I didn't, oh, my apologies for your very belated birthday wish from your mom and dad and Chloe. But a happy belated 18th, nevertheless, one way or the other, to Lakota Quinn Arnett. And I've got someone who's found a small dog in Sagersville. They found it Sunday afternoon. If you've got a lost pet, I've got a phone number for you. 349-7166. 349-7166 if you've lost a pet in or around Sagersville. I'll have the calendar back up and running tomorrow, just kind of scanning through nothing in the next day or so. The next blood drive in McGoffin County is Friday. The Bow Hunters Education class is Saturday. They're picking and grinning this Saturday at Kearney Free Will Baptist. And I've got some other announcements that I'll get to starting on tomorrow's program. I do have two funeral service announcements that I want to relay to you before we go any further. I came into the office to find out today that services were held earlier today for 73-year-old James Sherman Priest of Mount Sterling, who passed away on Saturday, survived by his wife, Terry McCarty Priest, sons Gary Allen and Larry J. Priest, and daughter Brenda K. Frazier. Services were held earlier today on behalf of their family and the McGoffin County Funeral Home. And I've also received an announcement from the Sagersville Funeral Home tonight for Vera Lou Howard Russell, 69 of West Liberty, who passed away on yesterday's date, preceded in death by her husband Joe Russell and son Billy Joe Russell. She survived by son Maurice Russell and daughters Laura Jordan, Sandra Watson, Lola Helton, and Heather O'Hara, as well as a host of other family and friends. Funeral services for, once again, 69-year-old Vera Lou Russell are going to be conducted this Friday at 11 o'clock from the Sagersville Funeral Home Chapel. Now, with all that aside, let's go on down to Miss Magoffin County this past Friday night, where Master of Ceremonies, our own Jim Caldwell from Magoffin County, meteorologist who lives in Lexington, of course, was on hand throughout the entire show, always entertaining and always ready to give us the announcements for those who have won in the crowning of our new Miss Magoffin County. We'll pick it up at the evening gown competition.
Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number one, Caitlin Sloan. All right, Caitlin, what is the most attractive aspect of being Miss Magoffin County?
The most attractive aspect of being Miss Magoffin County are its four pillars: service, style, scholarship, and success, because these are aspects that I believe in living throughout my daily life. Thank you.
Thank you. Contestant number two, Delaney Wireman. Delaney, how would you help other children in school from being bullied?
Through personal experience with bullying, I would advise every child to stay true to themselves and not let others get to them, because self-happiness is what's important. Thank you and good evening. I'm your contestant number two, Delaney Marie Wireman.
Number three, Laura Castle. Laura, regarding social media, how do you feel it impacts today's students?
I feel that social media has a positive as well as a negative side. The positive side being, it's easier for students to be able to stay connected throughout all their lives without having to not be face to face. The negative side being, it's easier for students to be cyberbullied, and it really shows that what we say really can hurt others, and we need to watch what we say. Thank you.
Thank you. Contestant number four, Taylor Altman. What makes Magoffin County feel so much like home to you?
Magoffin County feels like home to me because it is such a small town, and God has blessed me with so many wonderful friends that have molded me into the person that I am today. Thank you and good evening, Magoffin County. I am your contestant number four, Taylor Marie Altman.
Thank you. Contestant number five, Allegra Howard. Allegra, how does Alzheimer's affect a family's financial status?
Well,
Personally, if a family's individual has to be removed from their occupation, not only does it create a financial aid crisis for the family, but it causes a financial aid crisis for the victim and the victim's health and finding a cure. Thank you.
Thank you.
Forever remember being one of the greatest. Thank you and good evening, McGoffin County. I'll always be your Miss McGoffin, 2014.
Assisting with the awards and the crowning of the new Miss McGoffin County was a lady who we had to say goodbye to as she was about to relinquish her crown after so representing McGoffin County well over the past year, Lindsay Phillips, your former Miss McGoffin County. Who will take us on with the rest of the pageant committee to the awards ceremony, beginning with that of Miss Congeniality, of course, the award voted on by the pageant contestants themselves.
It's an award that the ladies voted on earlier this evening. They've been practicing for the pageant, and they've gotten to know each other, and I'll tell you right now, they all have the sweetest personalities. But the winner of Miss Congeniality is contestant number 5, Allegra Howard.
The next award is the Jenny Lou Caldwell Memorial Sunshine Award. Now, that's named in honor of my mother. And this award was voted on by the pageant committee. And that one goes to...
The pageant committee, of course, voted on this award. And we chose this year a young lady who has been just absolutely wonderful. She has been like a ray of sunshine. They all have, but this young lady, I feel, went above and beyond. She participated in Community Day. She participated in our roadblock. She's been very helpful, and she's just done everything that she was asked to do with a smile. So the winner of the Sunshine Award is contestant number 3, Laura Castle.
Now, the next award is the People's Choice Award. This award goes to the contestant who sold the most People's Choice tickets at this year's Community Day event. It was held this past August 16th over at the Ramey Memorial Park. And the winner of that is contestant number 3, Laura Castle. Now the next award is the Swimsuit Award. This goes to the contestant whom the judges feel presented herself the best in lifestyle and physical fitness in the swimsuit category. And the swimsuit winner is contestant number 3, Laura Castle. All right, next we have the Talent Award. The Talent Award goes to the contestant whom the judges feel expressed the best talent on stage this evening. And the winner of that award is contestant number 3, Laura Castle. Now, for our second runner-up. This young lady will receive a $100 scholarship, trophy and flowers from Town and Country Flowers of Salyersville. And our second runner-up is contestant number 4, Taylor Altman. Our next award is for the first runner-up. Remember, this is a very important role because if, for any reason, the winner cannot fulfill her duties, the first runner-up will assume the title of Miss McGoffin County. She will also receive a $250 scholarship, a trophy, and flowers from Town and Country Flowers. Our first runner-up is contestant number two, Delaney Wireman. Now, for our new Miss McGoffin County. This young lady will receive a $500 scholarship from the Miss McGoffin County pageant, an official Miss America local pageant crown, the official sash, flowers from Town and Country Flowers, and sponsorship to the Miss Kentucky pageant that's held in July in Lexington, Kentucky. Remember, one of these ladies right here before us is the new Miss McGoffin. And that young lady is, out of everyone on stage, Laura, you won Miss McGoffin County. Contestant number three. Ladies and gentlemen, your new Miss McGoffin County contestant number three, Laura Castle.
Laura Castle is the 18-year-old daughter of Frank and Sandra Castle of Staffordsville and a senior at Johnson Central. She hopes to obtain a master's degree in business administration and degrees in communications and American Sign Language. And she now can add to her resume, Miss McGoffin County, 2014-2015. Just one of the many pageant winners we would see in the parade the following afternoon, which began promptly at 1 o'clock in the streets of downtown Sagersville under beautiful, albeit warm, sunshine-filled skies and before a large crowd, and that's where we'll take you to next. Beginning, as always, with our local law enforcement and our Chapter 15 of the DAV this year. As is customary for the past several years, Betty Jo Likens was at the helm, announcing as the parade rolls through. We'll turn it over to her in just a few seconds, just to say a couple of remarks, now and then in between and later. I guess I'll work a word in or two. The Grand Marshal of the parade scene here was Ray Todd Preston, one of the many Lifetime Achievement Awards recognized by Sagersville Renaissance, all of which invited to be Grand Marshals for the Heritage Day Parade as it wound down for the first year of the celebration of its kind in grand fashion Saturday night with a street dance and a big crowd in downtown Sagersville, but not before the parade, which of course a whole lot of folks came from near and far to see.
And That's my girls.
They sure are beautiful, young ladies.
It's the team rider up. Rumpelstiltskin Nicole Allen.
Yep. Okay, this is Paige Lee Allen, and she's the first place winner in the girls 24 to 36 months. Congratulations. You're a gorgeous little thing.
Arabella yeah. Gray Stevens. Her mommy used to ride in pageants as winners, and she's a following in her footsteps. She's a pretty girl. 6 to 12 months. Emily Elaine Holiday, third runner up, 12 to 24 months. Oh, that's Tasha and Brandon's little girl.
She sure is a cutie.
She's a doll. I know her grandparents think so. We're real proud of you. Yeah.
Kara Rosner, I believe. Congratulations, Kara Rosner.
Oh, this is a spelling bee winner. Fourth place.
No, first place in the fourth grade.
In the fourth grade.
Congratulations.
South Montgomery Elementary. I used to teach school up there. Lindsay Elizabeth Warman. Tiny Miss McGossin.
He's telling us who he is. Braden J. Prater, he says.
Oh, I seen him the other night. He's something else.
He's the Heritage Day Children's Pageant Tiny Master winner, Braden J. Prater. Okay.
Tiny Miss McGuffin, Erin Grace Rudd. That little girl can sing, too, and she was also Little Miss Firecracker. You go, Erin Grace. That's her daddy, Steve, and I'm sure her mother and brother. Hey, Yellow Grace, first place winner, 12 to 24 months, Heritage Day. Yellow Grace Arnett, daughter of Minerva and Jeff Arnett. Oh, here's Rhythm and Grace. I wish you could have seen these little girls on the stage the other night. Three instructors are Lexi Bolin and Hallie Ann Ward. And these little girls can, of course, Tanya helps them out a little. Gives them moral support. But they can really get down and get it, I'm telling you. Hi, girls. Winner in the commercial.
In the youth.
Rhythm and Grace. What was the first place? Okay, here's a commercial for Long Care, Eastern Kentucky.
They won second place.
That's the commercial vlog, and they won second place. What's this? Rainbow Girls. Here's Rhonda Minix Howard. All right, in her group, I see Carly and Nancy and.
And they are second
place winner in the Civic Float. Madolphin County Rainbow Girls. Oh, look at her. This is Hudson Shane Minix. I mean, this young man is something else. He's first place winner in 6 to 12 months. There's 0 to 6 months. This is a first place. I don't see his name. First place winner, I don't see a name. Remington.
Oh.
Look how cute. Keep that umbrella over. Oh, look at here. Here's two, Malin Hunley and Lance Hunley. These are the children of Tiffany Likens and Jeremy Hunley. And Jeremy won third place, and Malin won first. Runner-up, Miss Teen McGolfin. Tiny Miss McGolfin. Mally Jo Reisner. I like that name. Little Miss McGolfin. Riley Ashton K. Andrea's daughter, and I'm sure you've seen a lot of things about her big sister. This is going to do well, too. Now, Mackenzie Bentley, this is the granddaughter of Dallas and Kay Bentley, Johnny's daughter. Okay. Aspen Neal Cone, isn't that a pretty name? First place, 0 to 6 months, Heritage Days. A beautiful girl with a beautiful name. Lauren Hunley, Junior Miss Firecracker. You're looking good up there. Sure, that's a good looking young man on it. Avery Page Allen, 6 to 12 months, first place. Congratulations, Avery. Chelsea Collinsworth, first place, Junior Miss. Looking good, Chelsea. Petite Master, Kenyon Oney, first place. Cole Russell, third place, 12 to 24 months. He's looking good. Like that sucker. This fella in the pageant the other night, and I saw him in the pet show, he just gets around all over the place. I'm telling you. Dominique Fletcher, first place little master. I like your entry in the pet show. Hunter Cobble, 0 to 6 months, first runner up. Turning around, so which one is he? That one? Okay, but what a pretty boy. Now, Miss Teen Firecracker, Kaylee Blanton. Bentley Connor Hard, first place, 12 to 24 months. You're looking good. Now, Layla Lynn Miller, 24 to 36 months, third place. That's a pretty girl. Look at her pretty, pretty hair. First place, Gregory Calloway O'Neill Jordan. Is that me, Jake's little boy? Hey, he won last year. Jagger, I love that name. Jagger Astaire White, second place, Tiny Master. I'm sure that boy was named after the...
Yeah, Astaire was named after Fred.
Maybe. This is McGoffin County softball champs. Congratulations, girls. Girls softball team.
They're second place winner in the
year. Unheard Isaac. Everybody knows who Caroline is. If you don't look on that sign. Here's another political sign. W. Kent Barney, judge for Court of Appeals. That's a dandy.
And it is the first place, the Ford 960 model, second place winner.
Second place winner.
That's Stanley Rose.
Stanley. Oh, look at that one.
J.B. Warman, a driver.
J.B. Warman, I'm telling you, you can't beat these farmers, can't Alice Chambers. And what's this one?
That is a John Deere. Right, that's like
a brand new. This is a brand new. That one's Dolphins Trail, yeah. Okay. Hey, let's pause for a minute to congratulate. I like that sound. Ella has the Oriental Band.
I like your costumes.
I do too. They've been married for years. This is still part of the group. Thank you guys. We sure do appreciate it. They're out of Ashland, Kentucky. Maybe some local guys in here. Like that music. Looking good. This is the Big Sandy Shriners Club. Stevenson, no Bobby Dean, and who's this guy? And in the little blue car, I don't know if I have to be up closer to you to tell who you are. What happens when... Look at us. I was thinking for the remote there for a minute. Yeah. Hillbilly. Number one. Good. Ella has a... I appreciate y'all getting out on a day as hot as it is.